and welcome to Down to Earth. Our question this week was sent in by Michelle, who has some photos of her vinca, which are having some issues. She wants to know what is making the leaves on her vinca fold up. Well, from the photos that I see, I can definitely say that these are leaf rollers. If you unfold those leaves, you'll either see frass, which means that the insects have already pupated and are now feeding or have fed and are gone, or you'll see the pupa, which looks like webbing. You may also see the little culprit himself, and he does look just like a small caterpillar. These leaf rollers are small caterpillars. There's many different species of moths and butterflies that have larvae with this type of leaf rolling growth strategy. Unlike some moths and butterflies, leaf rollers are not terribly host specific, such as your monarch and your milkweed, which only feed on that plant. I saw some leaf rollers on my buddleia in the early spring of this year, so those were obviously a different species because of the timing than this one that's occurring now. I consulted my colleague, Wizzy Brown, who's our entomologist, and she says that right now we're seeing quite a few leaf rollers on vinca plants. One substance that works very well on all caterpillars is BT. But when I have leaf rollers, unless it's a really bad infestation, I just live and let live, especially on a mature plant which recovers very easily. You can also use a contact insecticide containing spinosad or neem, or you can use a systemic that's labeled for the caterpillars that you're trying to kill. Another option is simply to remove those leaves and toss them out. On a small to medium infestation, that's probably your best option. On a large infestation, you may try to remove all of the infested leaves and let the plant recover. Those infested leaves won't recover anyway, but pruning the plant will encourage it to put on new growth. Our plant this week is silverleaf ponyfoot, Dichondra argentea. It's a great ground cover, it's evergreen, and it's grown for its beautiful silver light green foliage. It has a wonderful way of creeping along the ground and quickly filling in space. It also looks great in a container as the short element. It cascades beautifully over the edge of containers. It's low water use, it can handle light shade or filtered sun under trees, and it also loves the full sun. To do this week in your garden, you need to start looking for a brown patch, especially if you have St. Augustine. Our nighttime temperatures are cooling off, and the environment is perfect for this disease to take off. So you need to practice good cultural controls. Water only in the early morning and mow every 5 to 7 days, or more often if we're getting a lot of rainfall and the grass is growing quickly. We'd love to hear from you. Please visit klru.org/ctg to send us your question or a plant of the week from your garden.